Hi, I'm Aaron Rump, and I'm a machining instructor. But I wasn't always a machining instructor. In fact, a long time ago, I was a student in this very class that I teach now. So, in today's speech, I'm going to tell you about an experience I had during that machining competition and kind of tell you how that experience helped me, and with any luck, once I'm done, it'll help you too. So let's start with me being a student in the machining classroom. So I thought I was pretty good. I did pretty well, so I somehow convinced my instructor to let me compete as a contestant in a lathe turning competition. So what is lathe turning? So if you look up here, you'll see that this is a turning tool taking material off of a lathe. Pretty simple. So all I'm doing is I'm turning it, and then I measure these diameters to make sure they're in tolerance. So during the competition, I'm first one done. All my dimensions are in tolerance, I'm pretty happy. So I turn that in, thinking I've got victory under my belt. And then after everything was said and done, later in the day, we went to the awards ceremony. This is where I get pretty excited, because I'm thinking I've got this in the bag. So they start calling off the names, first name, second name, third name. After all the names are called, guess whose name wasn't called? Mine wasn't called. So I figure, what's the deal? My part was pretty good. I thought everything was in tolerance, everything looked good. So when I went to actually look at my part, I noticed nothing was in tolerance. So I couldn't figure it out until logic finally came back to me. Constant friction generates heat. So if you look at this, you notice I got a lot of sparks coming off of there. So that's what was happening. My part was getting hotter and hotter until all of a sudden, all my dimensions that were in tolerance, when that part cooled off, shrunk out of tolerance. So here I am left with a part that isn't in tolerance, and I'm in last place. So of course I took the loss hard, but I never stopped continuing my schooling until I ended up working in the manufacturing industry for over 17 years. So that was my way of taking that negative and turning into a positive and trying not to let it get to me too much. So now what do I tell my students that are going into the same competition that I didn't do so good at? Well, I tell them, try not to be too stressed during the competition, no matter how bad you're doing or think you're doing, because even if you get one dimension in, you're doing better than me. So to sum up my experience, it was a very humbling and motivating one. Humbling in the fact that even though I thought I knew a lot, I still had much to learn. Motivating in the sense that I took a negative and turning it into a positive so that I was able to go into the machining industry and have a successful career. So to sum it all up, I didn't ever think I would be in this position, but because of a willingness to do better, I overcame and became a winner. Thank you.